Guys, if you want to buy a cheap, safe NBA 2K MT, go check out safenbamt.com. Enjoy instant delivery, cheap prices, and safe, secure transactions. Make sure you use code WITNESS for a 5% discount. Also, guys, if you need to go 12-0 in My Team Unlimited, or you need to complete the Spotlight Series challenges, go DM DVDJ on Facebook or on Twitter. Their links are in the description, and use code WITNESS again for a 10% discount. Yo, what's going on, guys? Witness2K back on NBA 2K20. I just posted a pack opening video, but we're back right now. And yeah, we got a pink diamond on the screen. I decided to open up a couple singles, and we got a pink diamond right here. But this is not a pack opening video. In this video, I'm going to be telling you guys the best way, the quickest way to Evo these new cards that came out, because they're super easy to Evo. It is awesome that 2K have done this. Now, we're going to flip this pink diamond, so make sure you drop a like right now and subscribe to the channel. If you were new, I would love to see a pink diamond Bob Pettit. Here we go right now. I have no idea about the colors. It's Bob freaking Pettit. Let's go. Power forward from the Hawks, wearing the Chuck Taylors. We're going to get Bob Pettit right here. That is awesome. So that is a great way to start the video, is to pick up a freaking pink diamond Bob Pettit. Now, the Evo requirements are super easy for these cards. So we have this pink diamond Bob Pettit right here, and he needs 15 dunks to get his, he goes to a 98 or a 97, honestly, I don't really know, but he stays as a pink diamond. We only need 15 dunks, which is okay. He only has a driving dunk of 75 right now, but his standing dunk is a 90. So there is a certain way we'll have to do him. You know, then you have other cards like this dude. He needs to make threes with a 63-point shot. He'll be pretty easy to do in a game of not triple threat, of rookie domination. You'll have just a much better chance at hitting threes in rookie domination. So if you need to hit threes, go over to domination. He don't need steals. I think you could really just run him anywhere, you know. Preferably probably rookie domination. You're gonna have a higher chance at getting steals, and you can off ball because you're not playing online. But yeah, I think that's the main ones. You know, there is the rubies and stuff like Sean Livingston. He's only got a 45 3-point shot. He gets a massive boost though event when he gets evoed. You need to make 23s again, take it to rookie domination. DJ needs free throws. Obviously, that has to be like domination on My Team Unlimited. I would say domination, keep driving to the rim, getting the draw fouls. Markel Fultz, he already has an 80, so that's going to be really easy. Rookie domination again. Who else is in the set? We got Michael Carter-Williams, make 10 threes. He's got a 62, which is pretty solid for someone that you can just take to rookie domination again. Andre, rookie domination again. I would recommend rookie domination for most of them, all right? But then we're going to go over to collection. We're going to find out Bob Pettit. Now, like I said, he has a standing dunk of a 90. He is 6'9". So what we are going to do is match. We're going to play triple threat with him and match him with players that are taller than him. So we have our David Robinson, who's 7'1", and I'm trying to find my Giannis. So we have Giannis right here, who is 6'11". Giannis and David Robinson are both taller than Bob Pettit. That's what you want to do, is find two players that are taller than Bob Pettit. When you do that, you can go over to Triple Threat and add Bob Pettit. So he is going to be your smallest player. So he's going to play as your point guard on the squad, and he'll get matched up against his defender, will be the smallest opponent on the opposition's team. So I'm going to take these players over to Triple Threat Online. Triple Threat Offline, a fair bit of the time, it'll probably take you into a game with big men to match your opponent. But if you go in an online game, they're not going to know who you're going to, what players you're going to be running. So I could get matched up against a John Stockton or a Steph Curry or something like that. So we have an opponent, and we are going to be matched up against a Bradley Beal. Now, that was meant to be a standing dunk, but I had the wide open lane, so I just did the driving dunk. I don't even know if this dude is playing right now. So now that we are on, this dude's not even guarding me, so we can just go for the driving layup again, running baseline. It is pretty easy to get wide open dunks, but we can take the smaller opponents to the rim, possibly fake them out with a pump fake and then get a wide open just standing dunk because he does have a 90 overall standing dunk. I will try and do it. All right guys, so I've got two more dunks to go with this Bob Pettit until we can Evo him. We've got a mismatch right now. I need to get Spencer on us. We're gonna go for a layup right there. I've had three dunks alone just in this game. So the method I'm doing, I'm just trying to run baseline and get a baseline dunk. If I can't do that, I'll just back down the point guard and sort of spin off him. I'll just wait. I'll get Spencer if he can come with me. Don't get a switch. Grabs with two hands because why not? There's a lane. Ah, Zion's gonna be there. It's really hard because he's got such a low driving dunk, but I don't know, if you can get a good point, that point guard mismatch, it's all right. Our opponent's starting to break away with the win. I really don't care. There we go, so we ran baseline. I just need one more dunk. If this dude can just give it to me, it would be good, but I'm not worried about catching the win. I'm just trying to get dunks. All right, our opponent, we were able to get a stop. I don't know why this dude just doesn't want to let me just score. Like, I will save you so much time if you just let me get a wide open dunk. Might be it. There we go, all the way. Get out of here, bro. Like, for real, you got the win. Just give me one more dunk. So we're gonna try that method again. And Zion clears. There we go. That's exactly what I was talking about. It can be a little bit tricky to do. I did it a few times, just of course, as soon as I turn the camera on, it's gonna be a whole lot harder to do, but we've gotten all, let's go. Oh, that's out by us, apparently. We've gotten all the dunks we need. It's our ball. All right, whatever. We'll pull a three, we'll pet it. We may as well try and take this dub. I really don't care who wins, but we'll try and win this game. We've scored. We've gotten all the dunks we need. He wins right there, but again, I do not care because we can Evo this Bob Pettit now. All right, so you see right there the card evolution. It says we can evolve him right now. We've gotten the 15 dunks. We're hitting X. Make sure to drop a like right now and subscribe to the channel if you are new. It probably took us a total of four games of triple threat to get Bob Pettit to a 97, which isn't huge, but I guess the requirements are so not that exciting. But yeah, I'm probably going to sell him, to be honest. But with the other requirements, again, Rondo and DeMar DeRozan both need 33s. Easy done in rookie domination. You can get that done in one game per card. Then there is who else? This dude, 23s, rookie domination. Steals is a little bit tricky. I would go rookie domination while you're trying to shoot threes with other people on defense, just try and reach with Hedo Turkoglu. And then, yeah, then it's just same thing with the rubies. Threes, free throws, whatever, take him to rookie domination. But for Bill Russell needs threes as well. So if you want to get Bill Russell, he does need 33s. And I just agree again, go to rookie domination. But for that Bob Pettit being 15 dunks, I find it best to make him the smallest player in a triple threat trio. He'll, so you get matched up against the shortest opponent, and yeah, just bully him in the post, use the standing dunk, run around the side of the court, go baseline. That's how I found the best way to do it. So I hope this helps you out, guys. Make sure to drop a like right now and subscribe again. Shout out to the video goes to JJ Kansas. Shout out to you, bro, for commenting. I really do appreciate it. But I'll catch you on the next upload, guys. It's been witnessed.